Hello friends, let's begin with parametric representation of a line. This is the first analytical curve. Let's start. Lines. This is nothing but a basic entity which is used in a geometric modeling. As shown in the figure, if you observe properly, there is a line from P1 to P2, where P1 is the initial point, so it is considered as a U when we represent it in the form of U. So the U minimum will be 0, it's considered, and at P2 point you observe that U is equal to 1, that is U maximum value is given as shown in the figure. And there are vectors which are shown in the form of same names, where first you understand U is a point where P vector is observed. That is, O to P is a P vector as shown in the figure, and P1 vector is 0 origin to P1, and P2 vector is origin to P2. Okay. Where P2 minus P1 and unit vector n cap is shown in this diagram. Okay, so P at particular point P on a line, we assumed U, that is a parameter. So it will change the shape anywhere on the particular line. Remember this. So we will use simple equation, that is P is equal to P1 plus P minus P1. So P minus P1 upon P2 minus P1 is equal to U divided by 1, because U divided by 1 minus 0 will be there. So U minus 0 upon 1 minus 0, it is U by 1. So equation of our parametric equation of line becomes P is equal to P1 plus U into P2 minus P1 in 0 to 1 range. So in scalar form, it will be reflect as it. X is equal to X1 plus U into X2 minus X1. Y is equal to Y1 plus U into Y2 minus Y1. Z is equal to Z1 plus Z2 minus Z1. And all within the range of 0 to 1. Let's understand tangent vector of a line. Tangent vector is nothing but derivative of a line equation, that is dp by du. So here it is called as p dash, that is p2 minus p1. So x dash will be x2 minus x1, y dash will be y2 minus y1, z dash will be z2 minus z1. Then understand the unit vector, which shows the direction of a curve. So unit vector is p dash, that is tangent vector, divided by modulus of the tangent vector. Okay, so p2 minus p1 upon modulus of p2 minus p1. So modulus of p2 minus p1 is nothing but length of a line. Okay, so n cap will be x dash upon l I plus y dash upon j, y dash j upon l, then z dash k upon l, where l is the root of equation of line or distance of a line equation, that is x2 minus x1 square plus y2 minus y1 square plus z2 minus z1 square. Okay, let's begin next case, that is line starting from given points of a length and a direction. So straight line of a length L max starting from point P1 and direction of a unit, then P is equal to P1 plus L into n cap. Previously what we observed, same here we will do in the form of vector, unit vector. So P1 plus length into n cap, where L will be rangeable from 0 to L max. In previous case, it is varies U is varies in 0 to 1. So U is a another independent variable. Here length L is the another independent variable. Okay. So that parametric equation will be P is equal to P1 plus L into N cap, where L is modulus of P minus P1. So remember this. Case 3, parallel line. Assume that the existing line has two endpoints, P1 and P2, a length L1, and direction defined by a unit vector N cap. Okay. Or N1 cap. Then new line has the same direction and N1 cap as length is L2 and its endpoint P3 and P4. So it is called parallel line. The equation of parallel line is called P is equal to P3 plus U into P4 minus P3 in 0 less than or equal to U less than or equal to 1. So P L1 dash cross P L2 dash is equal to 0. That means lines are parallel. P L1 dash cross P L2 dash is not equal to 0. That is lines are not parallel. Okay. So this is a condition of parallel line. That is a vector equations. Okay. Next case, perpendicular line. If two lines L1 and L2 are perpendicular, the dot product of their tangent vector should be 0. So PL1 dash dot PL2 dash is equal to dot product of lines tangent vector is equal to 0 when lines are perpendicular, not equal to 0. That means lines are not perpendicular. Okay, it's simple. Whenever parallel line is there, cross product of tangent vectors should be 0. Whenever perpendicular line is there, dot product of tangent vectors should be 0. Okay. Next case, angle between two lines. Okay. Two lines L1 and L2 having endpoints are P1 and P2 and P3 and P4. The angle measurement is a command uses the equation cos theta is equal to P2 minus P1 dot P4 minus P3 divided by modulus of P2 minus P1 dot P4 minus P3. That means cos theta is L1 equation multiplied by L2 equation. Okay, that is a dot product. Remember, case 4, the distance of a point from a line as shown in the figure, a distance t from a point P3 to the line whose endpoints are P1 and P2 and direction vector n cap, it is length L. So d is represented as P3 minus P1 into n cap is equal to P3 minus P1 multiplied by P3 minus P1 upon modulus of P3 minus P1. Okay, it's a simple form. Thank you so much. Hope you understand well.